I'm Jordan Carlos, and it's time for Can We Talk About This?
I know it's detention, but I don't think I belong in here.
It doesn't get much more iconic than The Breakfast Club, but does this teen movie that defined teen movies still hold up? With me in Saturday Detention is a hilarious, hilarious comedian, Hari Kondabolu. Oh my gosh, The Breakfast Club was everything to me when I first saw it. But it's messy, it's a muddle, it's not black and white.
Literally not black. It's literally just white.
But what about you? You grew up in a diverse place like New York. What did you make of it?
I don't have this existence of being a white teen in the suburbs, but I know what it feels like to be in love with somebody. I know what it feels like to be angsty. I know all these different pressures that teenagers have. You find ways to relate. And it didn't really work the other way because they wouldn't put us on films because white people aren't going to be related to a black character or an Indian character. They won't understand. And when I hear that, it's like, oh, what you're saying is you can't relate to us as human beings. But we didn't have that choice as people of color. We have to see you as human. Otherwise, we have nothing.
I think movies like this are kind of like Sour Patch Kids. There's a lot of like sour nastiness, but there's some sweet in there too.
The sour you speak of is rampant homophobia and sexism.
Right.
The opening of the film, you know, it's just one of those casual 1980s high school hate crimes. John Hughes, really?
There's a moment where John Bender touches Molly Ringwald inappropriately under the table. It was played for laughs, but watching it now, it makes me cringe.
Oh, that was one of the biggest cringes I had, because I had forgotten that scene. Watching the first time around, he just comes off as the cool character, but when you look at it, it's like, this guy was awful. He did awful things, and somehow, despite all that, she falls in love with him by the end of the film. Mm-hmm.
Ally Sheedy at one point had to, in order to be accepted by these people, have a total makeover.
That's another weird thing that, again, maybe says a lot about how John Hughes views these kind of relationships and views women. It's like, so as soon as she changes the way she looks, Emilio Estevez is all about her. Oh, you're hot now. Let's do it. Like, it just...
But giving John Hughes credit, there's so much attention to detail. I mean, everyone's going through it, you know? And that, I thought, was relatable and another reason why the film works after all these many years.
One of the things I think John Hughes does really well in this film is that he gives all these characters backstories so you kind of understand, at least to some degree, why they are the way they are. This kid was abused, so he acts this way. This kid has parents who are in the middle of a divorce and they hate each other, so she acts this way. Mm. This kid doesn't have parents who pay attention to her, so she acts out this way. Like, stuff like that, I think, has a great deal of value, and that's the stuff that stands out. And, you know, in the, 30 years since, there's been tons of teen stuff that's definitely drawn from that and has learned from that.
I always feel like you should not avoid the reality of what things were like in the past. This is what it was, right?
Plus, it's funny. You know, that's the thing. It's still funny. It still holds up in terms of being funny. Like, there's lots of cringy moments now looking at it as an adult, but there's a lot of moments that are genuinely hilarious to me. Like, the fact that Brian is getting a fake ID in order to vote early.
You realize you made yourself 68?
Like, it's the only documented case of voter fraud ever. And it's in a fictional movie, and it's a white kid.
Hari, thank you so much for
Absolutely.
All your takes. They're fantastic. This has been Can We Talk About This? I'm Jordan Carlos. Enjoy the movie.